This video is to help you visualize the front, top, and the right side views of the objects in exercise 2.1. When you open up your text to exercise 2.1, you will see these 9 objects here. And the goal of this exercise is to draw the front, the top, and the right side view for each one. And you will be drawing those views on the gridded sheets located at the back of your book. And so you're going to carefully tear out a gridded sheet for each one of these exercises. The grid sheet for exercise 2.1 has the front, the top, and the right side view already drawn for object number 1 right here. So you'll actually be starting by drawing object number 2. You'll start this corner of the front view in this darkened corner that you see right here on your grid. Your top view will begin in this corner here, like this one did over here. And your right side view will begin in this corner, just like the right side view did on this one. There is a miter line, so you'll be able to, once you've drawn part of a view, if you want to project up to the miter line and then project across to find the corresponding grids, you'll be able to do that. And of course, you'll be able to just project straight across with the corresponding grids here. So you just need to count the number of grids on the sketch, come down to your corner, count the same number of grids. There's actually a video showing how to sketch this one right here. But the purpose of this video is to show you what the front, top, and the right side views of these objects look like, and using a 3D model. So here would be the front view of object number 1. Here's the top view. There's the front. And there's the right side view. And there's back to the front. And this we call the isometric view. Now this one's already done for you. So let's go to the second one. This is the first one you'll actually sketch. So here's the front view. And on this particular 3D modeler that I'm using right here, this is Inventor, this line here and this line here are showing up as solid lines, but actually, when you draw them, those will be hidden lines. So there'll be a hidden line here and here because this plane runs behind these two features, so they're going to be hidden. So let's go back to the front view. Rotate at 90 degrees to the top. That's your top view. Rotate back to the front view. Rotate from there 90 degrees to the right. There's the right side view. Back to the front view and then to the top. And you'll see there is a hidden line here and a hidden line here. That represents the sides of this hole at the very outside edge, which we would call the quadrant. And you have the same thing over here on this side. So I'll rotate it back up to there so you can see that. There would also be a center line running right down through the center, halfway between those two hidden lines on each side. And that center line represents the center axis. You would also have a center mark, a plus sign right here with some lines extending out a quarter inch past the edge of this hole. Go back to the isometric view. This is the third object that you'll sketch. Here's the front. The top, rotate back 90 degrees, rotate to the right 90 degrees, there's the right side view, rotate back 90 degrees, there's the front view, rotate toward the top, there is the top view. So we have an inclined plane here, we have an inclined plane here, take this across, and since this plane runs at an angle, we can see that in the front view, it is also an inclined plane in the top view. Go back to the front view, go to our isometric view. This is the fourth model. I can see there's going to be quite a few hidden lines in these views. You can see the dashed lines in these. So I'm going to go to the front view. So we have hidden lines for the top and the bottom of the hole. So let's rotate 90 degrees to the right side view. There is that hole. We can also see a hidden line coming across here. Let's go back to that. that represents the bottom of this half round cut. So we would project that across over to the right side view. That's where we're getting this hidden line here. And let's go back to here. We would see a hidden line for this edge, that surface right there in the right side view. So this line that the modeler is showing as a continuous line right here should actually be a hidden line. So let's go back to the front view. We'll rotate it 90 degrees to the top. There is our top view. There will be a center line running all the way through the center of that hole, and there should be a center line running vertically on that half round shape. So I'm going to bring that back to here. So you're going to have a plus sign right in here for the center mark. You'll extend lines out, extend the center line out, extend the center line down. So you'll have a center mark for the half round shape in the front view. Here is the fifth model. This is the isometric view of it. So let's go to the front view, the top view, back to the front view. Now, there's going to be a center mark in here with center lines extending out. And those center lines, or those center marks that run through here vertically, are going to align to where this plane comes up and meets this plane. So we have an edge right here. So when we rotate to the top view, we would normally have a center line running right down through the center here from north to south, but that center line is going to be covered by this hidden line, and that hidden line represents where this plane and this plane come together. The reason why we show the hidden line is there is a precedence for the views, and here's how it goes. Visible lines will cover any other line. Hidden lines will cover center lines. So in this case, even though we would expect to see a center line running north and south right here, that hidden line takes precedence over it and covers it up. So let's go back to here. Now let's go to our front view. And now let's turn 90 degrees to the right. We see our right side view. We will not see a visible line right here. That's just the way that this modeler is showing what we call a tangent edge, where this arc meets this vertical plane right here. But I want to show you that when you go over there, because that represents where the center of the hole runs through, instead of a visible line here, this should be a center line. And remember, a center line will start about a quarter inch out here in space. It'll go straight across, then there'll be a break, there'll be a short line, there'll be a break, and then a longer line running out to about a quarter inch past the edge. So let's go back to our front view and then back to the isometric view. This is model number 6. You can see there's quite a few features in here, so let's look at how those show up as hidden lines. Here is the front view. We'll rotate 90 degrees to the top. There is the top view. Quite a few hidden lines showing up now. So let's go back to the front view and see if we can figure out where some of those are. Well, some of those are the sides of this hole that goes through. Some of them are where this half round meets this plane here, and it forms an edge. So watch as I rotate to the top, and you'll see where those hidden lines show up right here. This one, the hidden line comes down, and then it blends into a visible line, and the visible line has precedence, and then the hidden line picks up again and shows out right there. Let's take this back. Now let's rotate it 90 degrees to the right, back to the front view, and then to our isometric view. Model number 7, front view. Now let's go back this view here. So we're going to see a visible line here and a visible line here, but they're going to be covered up by this plane that runs all the way across. So let's go back here. We see a hidden line right here. And the reason for that is there's a plane back there on its edge view. So let's go to the top view. This is our top view. There's that plane I was talking about that you could see. So let's rotate 90 degrees back to front. And now let's go to the right side view. Things get a little trickier over here on the right side view. The reason for that is that we're actually going to have a hidden line right here. That's showing up as a solid line, but it's where this edge goes along and then it goes behind this feature that's sticking up right here. So let's spin that around so you can see. Let's go to here. So you see this edge right here? It actually goes behind this. So when we look at the right side view, this should be a hidden line coming across. This will be a visible line. These will be visible lines here, visible across here. This will be visible here. Maybe I can just spin this a little bit. You can kind of see what's going on. You see how those are going behind these other features here? So let's go back to our isometric view. This is model number 8. Here's the front view. Notice the hidden line that runs here and the vertical hidden line that runs here. Let's see if we can figure out what those represent. When we go to this view, we can see that we have a vertical plane and that goes into an inclined plane and then meets another inclined plane coming together. And where they meet, where that line is right there, that will project forward, and we will see that edge right here as a hidden line running down. And the same thing is happening here. On the backside, we have an inclined plane meeting an inclined plane. So let's go to the front view again. So you can see where those hidden lines come together. So let's go to the, or where those planes come together to create that hidden line. So let's go to the front view, rotate to the top, rotate back to the front. Now I want to show you what we're seeing here. This hole that we're seeing right here is called a counterbored hole. So this is the counterbore. It is a flat bottomed hole. Goes in, it doesn't have a point like it has a drill bit on it. It's flat in the bottom. It just goes in a certain distance. And so then we have a flat plane. And at the center of that flat plane, we're going to drill another hole through or cut it through there, maybe using a mill or something like that. So when we see that in the front view, it looks like concentric circles. But when we turn it 90 degrees to the top view, it will be a hidden line that goes up, goes all the way across like that and down. These will all be hidden lines. That represents that flat back edge. And then this is the hole that goes all the way through. You would draw a vertical center line all the way through right there. So let's go back to our front view and let's go look at that in the right side view. Here's our counterbore coming in, and it actually, the flat edge that would normally be hidden would be right here. But that's going to be covered up by a visible line. And then we see the hole that goes the rest of the way through. This is the hidden line on the back side over there that's formed by this guy right here. So you can see that the bottom of the counterbore falls behind this visible line right here. So let's go look at it again. Front, top, front, right. Back to the isometric view. Part number 9. All right, so the front view of part number 9 will look like this. And so you see these two hidden lines, the two hidden lines we have here. I'm going to go back to the isometric view and see if you can kind of relate those to where they're coming from. So one of those hidden lines is where this vertical plane meets this inclined plane and runs across. And then also where this inclined plane meets this vertical plane, we'll see a hidden line. The same thing is happening down here on this edge. The hole only goes through one grid thickness right here. So let's go back to our front view. Now let's turn 90 degrees to the right. So there are the top and bottom edges of the hole as hidden lines. There will be a center line running from left to right, or right to left, depending on how you draw it. That'll run right through here for the center of this hole. Getting a message from my computer. Back to the front view. Now let's rotate 90 degrees to the top for the top view. So we're gonna have a hidden line that runs all the way across, even though my 3D modeler is showing that as a solid line. That would be a hidden line all the way across. These are the sides of the hole. there would be a center line that runs north and south to represent the center of this hole right here. So let's go back to this view here, the what we call an isometric view, and let's go to the front view, the top view, the front view, and the right side view, back to the front view, and back to our isometric view. Isometric views, one of the things about an isometric view, why we call it that, is that these lines that we call receding angles on these planes, they run at 30 degrees relative to the horizon, and this one runs at a 30 degree angle relative to the horizon. So when I mention the word isometric view, what we're talking about is a view that looks three-dimensional versus our front view and side view and top view, which look two-dimensional, right? Okay, back to the isometric view.